Comrades and lovers of our beautiful language, Kiswahili language, we proceed with the nyakati, times, different times. So today we are going to see somo la kumi na moja, 11th lesson. Repeat, somo la kumi na moja, somo la kumi na moja, 11th lesson. This continues dealing with the nyakati, different times. We are going to see how we use some terms concerning days, weeks, years, and so on. So we start by this word here. Jumatatu iliyopita. Jumatatu iliyopita. It means last Monday. Last Monday. The sentence says Alhamis ijayo. Repeat, Alhamis ijayo. Next Thursday. So these words you may use Jumatatu hii, Jumatatu ijayo, Jumanne iliyopita. I have just given the 2 days as examples, but you can use any of the days to show that this the next day or the last Sunday or next Saturday and whatever. And those are just examples. We move on. Jumahili. It means this week. Repeat. Jumahili. Move on. So the word Juma, for meaning week, and week in Kiswahili, it means the same. Somebody may say week hii or Jumahili. It means the same, this week. So if I say Jumahili, I mean this week, Jumahili. But also if I say week hii, I mean this week. So those are synonyms, Juma and a week. They mean the same, okay, in Kiswahili. We move on. Juma lijalo, next week. Repeat, Juma lijalo, next week. Another option, wiki ijayo. Likewise, it means next week. Wiki ijayo, next week. Wiki ijayo. So we have also Juma lililopita, last week. Juma lililopita, last week. Repeat again. Juma lililopita, last week. Wiki iliyopita, last week. Wiki iliyopita, last week. So as I said, Juma and a week are synonyms in Kiswahili. You may use Juma or week. We move on. Mwezi huu. Means this month. Mwezi huu. Repeat. Mwezi huu. We move. Mwezi uliopita. Last month. Mwezi uliopita. Mwezi uliopita. We have mwezi ujao, next month. Mwezi ujao, next month. Mwezi ujao. We have miezi iliyopita. So miezi means many months. It's the plural of mwezi. So we say miezi iliyopita, last months. Miezi iliyopita. Miezi iliyopita. Miezi ijayo, next month. Miezi ijayo. Miezi ijayo. Siku zilizopita, last days. Siku zilizopita. Siku zilizopita, last days. Siku zijazo, next or coming days. Siku zijazo. Repeat again. Siku zijazo. We move on. Mwaka means year. Mwaka huu. This year. Repeat. Mwaka huu. mwaka huu. Mwaka jana or mwaka uliopita. You may say jana by means last, uliopita means last. So jana and uliopita are optional. You may use mwaka jana or mwaka uliopita meaning last year. So repeat again, mwaka jana, mwaka uliopita, mwaka juzi. Repeat, mwaka juzi. Repeat again, mwaka juzi, that is last year but one. Mwaka kesho, next year, or you may say mwaka ujao. And so kesho and ujao, when connected with the year, it means next year. So you choose one, whether kesho or ujao, it all means the same. If somebody says mwaka kesho and another one says mwaka ujao, it all means the same. And there's also another option there down, mwakani. It also means next year. Mwakani. Repeat again, mwakani. We have again, miaka hii, these years. Repeat, miaka hii. Miaka hii. We move on. Miaka iliyopita, last years. Miaka iliyopita. Repeat again, miaka iliyopita. We move on. Miaka ijayo. Next or coming years. Miaka ijayo. Repeat again, miaka ijayo. Thank you so much for listening and watching. I just invite you to the next periods and lessons. Thank you so much.